Does it feel like it's been 50 years?
Feels like it was yesterday.
It was April 4th, 1968 in Memphis, Tennessee. Before Andrew Young was an ambassador to the world, before Jesse Jackson became a reverend and a groundbreaking political figure, they were two young men dedicated to the cause of equality, led by Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., and it was a chilly Thursday afternoon at the Lorraine Motel.
I was talking to him, telling him he needed a coat, and he sort of raised his head to kind of see, test the weather, and pow.
A single shot to his chin, and King was dead. He was 39 years old. Now, a half century later, Young and Jackson returned to the very spot where their friend and leader was assassinated.
His shoes got caught under here, and it knocked him out of his shoes.
A photographer who was staying three rooms down snapped this iconic image as King lay dying.
Now, we were pointing over there because the police were here. They were running over this way, and we were trying to tell them to go back that way. That's where the shot came from.
Do you think he heard the shot?
I don't think he heard the shot or felt it. I think it was a beautiful death. My first reaction was to be mad, and the second reaction was to say, well, if anybody is entitled to a reward, you have sure earned it. And, you know, take your flight to heaven.
Young went on to serve as congressman, as U.S. ambassador to the United Nations, and as mayor of Atlanta. Jackson continued social and political activism and ran for president twice.
Every move I made, whether it was a demonstration or running for the presidency, I always felt his spirit and somewhere I touched base with him before doing it.
Jackson, now 76, and Young, 86, say King did not fear death. And even as they stand on the balcony that was once stained with King's blood, they're convinced that he will never die.
I've been to 152 countries. I've never been anywhere where people have wanted to ask me about Martin Luther King.
If he'd be 89 years old, he'd be just an old preacher who preached great sermons. His martyrdom is power. His spirit is alive.
Victor Blackwell, CNN, Memphis.